Your boy's here. I'm a little happy about this one. We have Tech N9ne's AllG'sReact. Now, let me get into it. I heard What If It Was Me in December. It came up for some reason. I think because I watched Am I a Psycho, which I'll get into all that here in a minute. But I end up watching What If It Was Me. I watched that thing. I listened to that song at least like, no, I watched the video at least 50 times that month by itself. Because that was a dope video. And the song itself is so real. There's so many elements in that song. I think some people even miss who do like it. So, Tech N9ne, I don't know if this is new or old, but this one's AllG'sReact. The interVENTion. This is the official music video for Tech N9ne. Now, we're going to dive in, and I'm going to talk a little bit about Tech N9ne, music, and everything like that after the video, because I actually want to see this. If this is real as What If It Was Me, gonna be what it is. What it is. Alright, let's do this. Alright. And
here we go.
Question for the maker. Okay, get the face paint going.
AllG'sReact. This the way it's supposed to be, huh?
Alright. That's a good question.
Sipping. A glass of red wine right before bedtime, thinking everybody down here tripping. If you up there upstairs, this is Nina telling you to listen. The vision I'm giving, everyday life is dumping on us like a pigeon. I give me the enemies with this Forbes list, but I get
real
energy from piss poor pricks. Can I get to heaven? All I get is threatened every time I get more chips. Got a grip for
ain't fits. No heaven here,
but I'm sick for assists. I gotta fight all of the night with cops, crips, bloods with sore fists, and them Nazis when I him Haji. Up at ain't too many men godly, hideous. So many cities busting Ferguson to Libya, Benghazi,
around the world.
The quality never been a level playing field, man. It been wobbly. So many circles of sin robbed me. That's why we go angel to grim Cosby, yelling this to my superior.
I gotta remember that line. Right, man, I got kids. I could never think about burying my kids, man. A lot of people don't understand. Them other countries, they burying their kids because of drone attacks and stuff from us. And your rights.
And yeah, we gotta bust, cause we packing a piece. Choke not another one of us for the snapping police. Who the hell a brother gonna trust when it's always dishonor? Hate me like Obama. And I ain't even got a runner asking you the question, God, what about my mama?
Music.
I remember that interview. He did say his mama died. I watched a little interview with him where he said his mom died. Okay, hold on. He said some stuff in here, man. Give me 1 second. I gotta find it. Okay, I could never think about burying my children, period. All right, people understand, like, we over here in the States, we get terrorist attacks on us, like, and then it's like instant hate, you know what I'm saying? But the thing is, that causes, like, that's loss of life, all right? And we don't want that, and we hate that. But what we don't see is the other side of it, to where you got people who are living in a building who just there, you know what I'm saying, with kids and their family, working. They like us, but because somebody who's involved in terrorist activity lives maybe three doors down from them, who they don't even know, and a drone strike comes from the U.S. taking that person out, and now that family gone. But you ain't gonna see that reported on the news or anything like that. Okay, so what we gotta remember is the hate we have for terrorist activity here is the same type of hate they have for terrorist activity that they label us as terrorists over there. Because there's some people who died over there, just like over here when we get bombed or when someone shoots something up in a terrorist activity. That type of stuff is happening over there. And when we bomb over there, and when we drop drone strikes over there, and we kill innocents, they ain't reporting that stuff to you. It'll make you think differently. They want you on U.S. side, which is, that's just how it is. So you got to think about it. But what he's saying is, I could never imagine burying my children. You know what I'm saying? Like, I could never imagine doing that. Like, I don't want to do that. I got kids. You know, and he mentioned Nigeria. He said something else in here, though, that was real. Hold on. There it is. Human equality ain't never been no level playing field. It's been wobbly. That is a sick line, and it's some of the most truth you would hear come from some people. For him to say that in a song, that is true. I mean, ain't nothing equal here. Ain't nothing fair here. None of it. And he says something else that goes in line with it too. Hold on. There you go. They gotta suffer the penalty because of education. So that right there is it. If you don't get no good education, you end up working for somebody for some shit pay, shit benefits, and you'll just continue that cycle in your life. That right there is real, because there's better schools in certain areas. There's some people in bad schools who's not getting that education, and now they got to suffer the penalty just because of that. Just because the school's not teaching you something. I'm yet to see schools teaching about finances, teaching people how to do their taxes, teaching people the tax system, about interest on these cars and houses. Where is that at? You gotta go to college 4 years to learn that? That should be in high school, because that's what you're gonna enter into when you leave high school. They gotta suffer a penalty because of education. That goes right in line with human equality has always been wobbly. And it never been a level playing field. It's been wobbly. Them two go together. And you put that in here. Sick. Now, I'm talking about Tech N9ne. Love Tech N9ne. Knew about Tech N9ne a long time ago. Didn't buy no albums until 6s and 7s. That's the album I bought. Now, I'm going to tell you why. I was born in Massachusetts, but I was raised in Arkansas. So I came from Arkansas. Coming from Arkansas, our music was Southern music. So we was getting fed a lot of Texas music. So when I came to Oklahoma, they didn't know about Texas rap like that. But they had their groups that they knew about, and Tech N9ne was one of them. So someone was playing Tech N9ne for me. I'm like, man, this dude pretty tight. You know what I'm saying? Like, this dude's pretty tight. Because I like speed rap. Didn't really get into him. Heard songs throughout the years. You know, early early 20s, you know, this is the bootleg era. I ain't buying no music. Bootlegging everything. All right, there's a bootleg man in like every laundromat parking lot. Just I'm not buying no legit stuff. I can get it for the five. So I didn't start buying music till I got up into like my mid-20s, when I got a craft, started making some money, got sick of dealing with bootleg stuff, bootleg movies. I had one movie. We watched the whole movie, good quality and everything. Last 10 minutes of the movie, they start speaking a different language. It was like Mandalorian. So it was something. They were speaking a different language. Like, the whole movie was in English, bro, until the very end. So I don't even know what was said. So I just got sick of dealing with bootleg problems, basically. Start buying music. So knew about Tech N9ne and all that type of stuff. But it wasn't until 6's and 7's album I actually broke down, because he delivered two God-tier collaborations on that album. One was Worldwide Choppers. If you know it, you know what I'm talking about. All the people on there. But the people he got to be on there, that's what I'm talking about. And his very own delivery on the song. Second, Am I a Psycho? Some of y'all might be like, whatever. Nah, Am I a Psycho? Sorry. Himself, Hobson, man, and my boy B.O.B. That's God-tier collaboration right there. If you don't believe me, he's one of the very few rappers to me who delivers God-tier collaborations. You got Fragile with him and Kendrick Lamar, and B.O.B. did the beat. And Fragile is sick. Bro, he Sriracha with Logic. Jason Lucas, I think is his name. Yeah, I think that's his name. See, I don't know him that well, but Logic, my boy. The Logic. He can deliver God-tier collaborations. That's why I was like, I'm start buying this stuff. Because I'm going to get that. And that's what I want. So, Tech N9ne. Tech N9ne, this is for you. If you happen to come to my 10 subscribers, 100 view total channel, you just, you know, strolling through, looking at the scrubs of the YouTube. If you hear this, if you can get a collaboration going between yourself, J. Cole, Big Crit, Hobson, Logic, Kendrick Lamar, if you can do that, if you can make that happen, I ask that I get a copy so I can put it in my casket for when I die. Because that's all I'm going to listen to in African, when I'm dead. That's it. I'm like, turn it on before you stick me in the ground. Put it over my ears. That's all I want. I'll be good. I'm going to put that song on repeat too. Get them good batteries. I need to listen to this at least 8,000 times while I'm down here. Get them good batteries. Alright. In fact, just give me like one of the battery packs that hold like a bunch of chargers on it and just plug it in. Throw me in the ground. That's what I listen to. But I'm telling you right now, man, as long as he stays alive and healthy, he's going to keep delivering God tier collaborations. And he's an elite artist himself. An elite lyricist himself. Love some Tech N9ne. This was sick though. Like, I knew what if it was me was good. This is sick, man. Human equality has never been a level playing field. It's been wobbly. They gotta suffer. I can't remember. Anyways, sick. This was sick. Let me know what you think in the comments about the boy Tech N9ne. What you thought about this song? Cause this was sick. Hopefully I don't get copyright strike over it. Please don't. Because I actually want to put this up and keep this up, because this, I want people to go listen to this song. I want you to listen to Tech N9ne. He has some good things to say. But anyway, man, I love Am I a Psycho. I love Hobson, man. I love VLB. Love them boys. Anyway, your boy's out, all right? So, as always, here, AllG'sReact, your boy Josh is Nixon.